हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ मैनाक फ्रॉम सिविल सेंटर। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी डे टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वीडियो। आई एम गोइंग टू मेक अ स्मॉल मॉडल इन द टेक्ला स्ट्रक्चरल डिजाइनर एंड आफ्टर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू मेक द स्ट्रक्चरल ड्राइंग ऑफ दैट स्मॉल पर्टिकुलर मॉडल एंड द फाउंडेशन लेआउट, प्लिंथ बीम लेआउट एंड टिपिकल यू नो द फ्लश फ्लोर बीम लेआउट सो दैट वी कैन डिजाइन यू नो एनी प्रोजेक्ट प्रैक्टिकली। सो मेनी पीपल हैव आस्क्ड डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग दैट and that we cover you know entirely in our full course. You will get experience from me for 30 days. You will get to spend 1 hour each day with me and for the entire course. But those who are for our YouTube viewers, I just want to, because if we can learn themselves, so for them I just want to present an idea how we can arrange you know drawings practically so that we can use the results of the Tekla structural design and make them into a practical executable structural drawing like this, where we have similar footing sizes, similar beam sizes, but definitely in the software we won't get that much similarity. How we get the similarity, how we group things, so all those practical concepts we'll discuss. And if you want to know about that, I'll suggest you that you can join our training on Tekla structural designer. That investment would be worth it if you really want to make your career in the field of structural engineering. Okay, so you know, after having said that, let's get started with our session. So let's get started with it. First of all, this is our Tekla structural designer and this is the new file in it. And also, yeah, we keep coming with new videos every single day. And okay, I'll just need to save this. I'll save it in my one particular folder. Let's give it in my downloads THT1 and I'll save it this now. So once we have opened this particular file, we have already made many videos on how to give the modeling and the design. So we'll design as per IS codes, Indian codes. So I will go to model first and go to construction levels and insert a level below it. This will be our foundation level. Let's give a minus 1.2 meters to it. This is the plinth level and insert a level above it. And this time we'll give SSL, structural slab level, source we'll keep as this unique, and spacing will give us 3.2 meters and slab thickness of 100 we'll consider. And so this is G plus 1 and I can go, so this is only G, let's go G plus 1. So G plus 1 is done, and after that we'll just go click on OK. So after that, when this is done, I will just make our construction levels. You can view the construction levels here in the levels option. And these are the construction levels. So let's create some grids in here. So rectangular wizard, and here using the rectangular wizard we'll create some simple grids. You can also import the DXF, the feature is there, but here we'll create some simple grids, length of let's say 4 meters, and next, and 2 of length. Here we have length of 4 meter. Let's give a little bit different, like 6 meters, and keep this as next, and then finish. And here we want to place the columns and beams, so let's take the columns now. So suppose here I want to place columns of size, here we want columns of size 250 cross 300. Orientation will be kept like this, and we'll just have this click on OK. And after this we'll tick on this automatic alignment and tick on hit, and then just click on this Fe500 because we want to use Fe500 steel, and save this, and we'll do C250 cross 300 and then click on OK. And after that we'll just apply it, and you know, after this has been done, you can change the orientation. If you can see, measure this distance. This distance you can see 4 meters, and this distance is 6 meters. So see, this is more in this case orientation will keep like this, but for this distance is 4 meters and this distance is 6 meters. So all these three orientation will be kept like this, but you know, this is the orientation which needs to be kept in all the columns. But if it was somewhere like this is different, then we could do it differently as well. So we'll quickly insert our beams. So first of all, in this is the plinth level, so let's try with beams of size 250 into 300, and this one will take as 250 cross 300 beams, and after that click on OK and save this particular file B250 cross 300 particular beam, sorry, and then just apply this beam this level. So this is the plinth level. This doesn't contain any slab because you have the periphery wall, you know, around it, and inside it you do the sand filling. So you don't have any slab in this particular plinth level. So we'll go to the next level and we'll insert, we'll make this source as base. Click on OK and then go to construction levels and make the source back as unique. So after do that, we can insert our slabs here and structure one and slab on beams. So we suppose that this portion is used for the staircase, so we'll leave that because one portion you need for the staircase. So just assume that this is for the staircase, so we'll leave this particular slab portion and go to construction levels and make the top floor as one and then click on OK and then we'll make this top floor back as unique. So I'm trying to simulating the model, actual building model, as far as possible using this building model. So now once you have made these floors, next thing is you need to apply the load. So let's go to the base first, and the process which I show is you know, is my experience the best process and the fastest one. So I'm showing you that, sharing with you that load, and then we'll select the date here, and after that we'll go full UDL and outer walls. I'll go 6. If you're using AAC block, this is pretty much the weight. Outer walls of the 10 inch, it is 6. If you want to see the video on load calculation, please comment. I'll just share you the link. It will be easy for you to do that. And inner walls, I'll apply 3.5 for the 5 inch walls. This has a staircase, so here I'll go with 6 because we assume that here we have the staircase. So in the bottom portion, you have this 2D, 3D option. Here you can really check about the click on escape, by the way, to you know, turn off the loading part. Here you can check the loads which are acting. This is the load of 3 kN, this is the load of 6 kN. So here you can easily visualize the loads, and if you, there is any error in this particular model, suppose if you haven't applied a particular load of you know, 10 inch walls or the outer walls or the internal ones, then you can easily check that. So this you can do, and you can go to the structure 3D, and if you turn on this load here, dead load, you can keep checking here also. So we'll go back to our structure one, which is our ground floor roof and our floor for our first floor. So this is it, and here we'll quickly do a same thing, dead, and go to full UDL and take the load of your 6 kN and apply it on the outer walls. It depends like what you know, the thickness of the wall you are using, so it really depends on that. So it can vary. I'm saying it again and again. So I'm just applying 3 in this portion. And after that, you can check again whether it is correct or not using this option. And after that, quickly go to this option of imposed, and then go to level load for residential. As per Indian codes 875 part 2, we apply imposed load of 2. And this is the structure 3D. And if you can check the imposed load also, this will show the imposed load. You can change the value. So it's very cool feature. You can change the value from here also. Suppose I want to, let's say just for example 1.8. And you can see the 1.8. I'm just giving a higher value just to check you, show you the, you know, variation. So here it will be 10. So like this, it keeps on changing. So I'll move it back to 2, and here it is 2. So like this, it keeps on changing. So we'll go to top floor. In the terrace level, the loads are different. Definitely, the load of the parapet wall, or you can say the boundary, or the which acts along the perimeter of the or the terrace floor. So here we'll just do dead, and we'll do full UDL. And we'll go with a load of 2, that is for the parapet wall. And this parapet walls are generally 1 meter in height, and I'll go 6 for the staircase part. 6 for the staircase part, and since there's a terrace, there will be no inner walls here. So this is a small structure, but it covers really everything. And in here, let us apply the imposed loads also, imposed, and then level load, and then level load of, let's say, a 2, and this level load has been applied, imposed load, and these are the dead loads. So you can check the loadings easily, very very easily, very easy process is here. And after that, we can just validate the model. Is very important. If you have any member collision, if you have any error warnings of your member intersection, all you can solve out using that. So once we have done this process, we'll go to your option of your loadings, and if you want, you can design for the seismic load as well. And some people don't design the seismic load for, you know, G+1 building, so they don't do that. It's optional, so you can design for that also, but right now I'll not do it. I'll skip it. I'll just simply create the load combination for the dead loads and the live loads, generate, And if you're thinking why people don't generate the seismic load for low-rise buildings, because it increases the quantity of steel, so that's why they don't it. But in our professional projects, we apply the seismic load and then we design. So you can check out the videos in which we have applied the full process. So after having done that, you simply go to design and design all static. Now in this design, the plinth beams may have some warnings. You don't have to worry about that, and especially the warnings in the plinth beam due to some axial force and due to some other factors. So yeah, this was expected that in the just to do none in these floors, the beams should have been a little bit thicker. So here we'll go with let's say these two levels, these two floors for the beams. I hope the beams are selected. I think here beams are selected, beam spans, and we'll go a depth of 350. So this goes here goes 350, and after that here I hope that it should have been passed by 300. So we'll check it later. So as you can see, this is pass actually, fail 0.33 ratio. So it is passed. So we'll go design and design all static. And this is passed. So we'll just simply check the review and go to ratio. We'll not worry about the warnings bit little bit. As you can see, the ratio is fine, nothing is failing, and the utilization ratio is fine. And so yeah, we can proceed with the model here. So because like when you have designing, so just check whether the beam is failing longitudinally. As you can see, the beam is 0.87, it is passed. So it is passing comfortably. You can check one reinforcement also, right click on a particular column and go to this option of, so it's hanged again. Do it, go to the option of design member static, and you'll check out this particular four bars of 16 mm. So this is fine for the columns. I'm comfortable with this. And after that, I'll just go and put the footings here, foundation and pad base column. Really, you need to check the particular this thing, soil unit weight and the allowable bearing capacity. You need to put as per the soil test report. After that, just simply select the entire model, applied automatically, design pad bases, and pad bases will be designed. So one, comfortability in the terms of StatPro is that, as you can see, the footings are economical. So practically, where the footing size we provide, they provide nearly around that. So that's one benefit of this particular thing. And let's start the structural drawing. But I think the video will be too much, so I'll upload the video in two parts. And or else let's just meet tomorrow. So we'll meet tomorrow in the same time. We'll upload the next video of in which we'll do the structural drawings of footing and then beams and then columns. We'll do the entire process. So see you tomorrow. Bye bye. Have a good day.